But do we really know what that means for our individual organs? Holistic nutritionist Andrea Donsky is back with the top foods we can eat right now to support our organs. It's so important. We're going into overindulging season, right?
We are. Lots of drinking.
Yeah, lots of drinking. So we need to support our organs.
We do. And in nutrition school, the first thing we learn is about how food affects our body and specifically our organs. So I thought we'd have fun today by doing a nutrition lesson.
Okay,
a quick one.
Break it down.
So we're going to start with our liver. Now, the liver takes the brunt of everything now that we're coming into holiday season. And our liver is the master filter in our body. It filters our blood, it detoxifies all that alcohol and prescription drugs, mm-hmm. and it basically keeps us energized.
Okay, so what are the no-nos when it comes to what we're eating wrong to support the liver?
All right, so first of all, how we know we need to even support our liver is that we're exhausted, we get acne, we have eye issues, dry eyes, blurry vision. So those are some symptoms that you know your liver needs some detoxing.
Okay.
So the things that we want to eat, greens, bitter greens, those are great for the liver, beets, garlic because of the sulfur, the onion, grapefruit, green tea. It's very high in antioxidants, which is amazing. And, you know, our liver loves beets as well. So the key is when it comes to the liver, you want to stay away from oils.
Oh.
Because the oils act as sludge. Even the good oils, even the avocado oils, even the olive oils, they act like sludge in our liver. And they stop it from working optimally. So what I do and what I recommend is having a liver-loving lunch. You can make yourself a salad. You can put on some lemon. Lemon is great for the liver, even in some warm water in the morning.
Walnuts.
Some walnuts. And then make yourself a salad dressing that is oil-free.
How?
I put in some Dijon, some apple cider vinegar, some lemon juice, some Himalayan salt, and you have a delicious dressing that you can use, and your liver will love you for it.
Beautiful. Next organ.
All right, so now we're going to talk about the colon. Our colon is the last part of our digestive system. It's part of our large intestine, and it's responsible for many things. We talk about a lot about the colon, probiotics, immunity, digestion. So when it comes to the colon specifically, you want to make sure you get 25 to 35 grams of fiber a day.
Okay.
And the key and why we want that is it helps to move things along and eliminate.
Move it through. So what does that look like, that many grams? First of all, this is what you shouldn't be eating, which is the processed.
We should not have any of the white stuff because there's no fiber and there's no nutrition.
Okay.
So the other thing when it comes to digestion, you want to eat a lot of fruits and vegetables that have your fiber, right? The other thing when it comes to the colon is fermented foods. We want our probiotics. So you want to have foods like kefir and kimchi that have probiotics that, again, will put it into our colon. And one of the key foods it was very trendy this year when it comes to our colon is bone broth.
Yeah, you're hearing a lot about that again.
Bone broth is amazing for many reasons. It nourishes the colon. It helps to heal the colon. It's great for our digestion, but it also has collagen. We talked about collagen last time I was on the show. It has anti-aging benefits, but it also reduces inflammation. So it's such a great food to have if you're looking to heal your colon.
Okay. And do you eat these? It doesn't matter, raw, steamed, cooked, equally beneficial?
I mean, I'm a big fan of having a little bit of everything, right?
Yeah.
So a little bit of raw, you're going to get your enzymes. If you can't tolerate raw or you like cooked, you can cook them as well.
Okay. Next organ, the thyroid. So many of us have problems. How do we know if we have a problem?
All right, so you'll know you have a thyroid problem if it's underactive, if you have cold hands and feet, you're really tired. Like I know when I had my thyroid issue, I could not get out of bed. I was exhausted. You're constipated, you can have depression. I mean, these are all symptoms that you have an underactive thyroid.
Okay.
Now the key when it comes to the thyroid is it needs several nutrients. Number one being iodine. So our thyroid needs iodine to function properly, but so does our reproductive organs. Super important.
Which is in table salt, but you have an even better solution.
I do. So okay. table salt is bleached, right? So I'm not a big fan of table salt. So what I recommend is for iodine is seaweed.
Okay.
Seaweed has 100% of our daily recommended value of iodine. And it's so easy to make. You can make yourself a seaweed salad. I made this last night. Throw in some delicious dressing, some sesame oil, rice vinegar. And it tastes amazing. The other thing when it comes to iodine is yogurt. I love this grass-fed yogurt from Rolling Meadow, but you can have any type of yogurt. It has naturally occurring iodine, and this is grass-fed, so it has no pesticides and no antibiotics.
Now, everything you read says stay away from cruciferous vegetables, i.e. cauliflower, kale, that, you know, tofu. Eating these things, especially raw, can actually cause you to have a thyroid problem. Is that true?
I love that you asked me that, and I knew you were going to ask me that. So that's why I did a lot of research before we came, and what I found was all the experts agree is that the benefits outweigh the risks of eating these type of foods. So cruciferous vegetables like kale, cauliflower, broccoli, they actually prevent thyroid cancer. So it's super nutritious to have. Our bodies need the cruciferous vegetables, especially our thyroid. And you really, unless you're eating tons and tons and tons and tons, all experts agree that it's perfectly safe.
Really?
In
any
proper
form?
Amounts, in any form.
Okay, we didn't have enough time to get to adrenals, which is, I know, very close to Kevin's heart. So maybe we can continue this a little later. He talks about how this
shift. Oh my gosh.
kills the adrenals
or stress. So important. The adrenals are so important.
At Naturally Savvy at 8:30. Awesome.
All right.
Can you stick around?
Yes, I'm sticking around.
She's sticking around for adrenals, everybody.
Awesome.
BreakfastSalvage.ca for more information. We'll have part two to wrap it up after this. Thanks,
Perfect.
Andrea.
Yeah, it's great.